On the year we've had of 2021. Now, there has been some really funny memes going on where it's like, all y'all who want to claim that 2022 is your year, sit the F down, be quiet, and do not touch anything and approach slowly. It's been so funny. I love dad jokes, so like stupid funny jokes like that just make me die laughing. There's been so many of them coming up. Even Mama Hendrix saw one of the ones I posted and was actually laughing, which is rare because she usually just rolls her eyes at my dad and I when we have so many stupid jokes. Oh, it's so much fun. So, today I'm going to focus on some facts to round out the year we've had for 2021. We're going to talk about the top box office hits, some of the most successful streaming apps, some of the most successful trends that we found in 2021, the top baby names, and so much more. We're going to dive into the crazy wild year that we've had thus far as we close out 2021 and look to anew in 2022. Okay, so here we go. You guys ready? We're going to start off with the top box office hits in the domestic box office for 2021. And what was really, really cool about this is these actually reflect something we had previously talked about on Talks with Taeler Hendrix with the successful year that Marvel has had in the theatrical releases in the domestic box office. So I actually learned some cool things, and then I also verified some things that we have talked about on previous episodes. That's really, really cool to kind of see everything come full circle as we close out 2021. So, here are the top five box office theatrical releases that had the top grossing numbers in the domestic box office this year. Coming in at number five. Oh, actually, I'm doing a top 10. So, we're going to do the top 10 now. That's right. So, as an honorable mention, coming in at number 11 was Dwayne The Rock Johnson in Jungle Cruise for Walt Disney Pictures. And that grossed a staggering $116,987,516. That's the honorable mention. Now, you guys are going to notice some really cool things, or at least I noticed. One of the things I noticed was Disney and Marvel coming up quite a bit in the top 10, which goes back to something we talked about with Marvel claiming the top five spots for theatrical releases in the domestic box office. The other studio that had a really good year is Sony Pictures, and you'll see that coming up very soon. So to round out the top 10, we have coming in at number 10 was Ghostbusters Afterlife, which surprisingly did way better than the projections for that film. It was produced by Sony Pictures, and it gained, and or if you want to call it grossed, in the domestic $120,450,060. Whew, wow, that's a lot of money. Yikes. Coming in at number nine, I have yet to see this, but I've heard really good things. I've only seen a few clips. Coming in at number nine for the top 10 grossing films of 2021 was Free Guy, starring Ryan Reynolds with 20th Century Fox. It gained or grossed $121,626,598. Coming in at number eight, which was one of the trending films that used a hybrid release strategy, and it did way better than people projected for that film. It came out, I believe, the same weekend as Cruella, and they both did way better than was projected. Coming in at number eight for the top 10 grossing films of 2021 from Paramount Pictures is A Quiet Place 2. They garnered $160,077,007. Coming in at number seven, another interesting film. We talked about this a lot on the Talks with Taeler Hendrix podcast and my YouTube channel. Number seven is a holdout for MGM Studios. It was No Time to Die, the latest in the James Bond franchise and the last of the franchise to star Daniel Craig. It gained in the domestic box office $160,772,007. Hey. We had two movies that ended with $7. That's fun. Coming in at number six. Now, I haven't seen this yet, and like I'm really far behind, but I really, really want to see it. I think the hype was really, really huge for this one, and for whatever reason, it did not gain the same sort of oomph, that pow pun intended, for CBMs, also known as comic book movies, which is very interesting. It's very odd. Maybe if I watch the film, I'll kind of understand why. But I was expecting more as far as revenue for this film. It was a Walt Disney and Marvel production. Coming in at number six was Eternals, which gained 160.